to this event, and I'm just now realizing.
Well, sir, every now and then you like to dabble in the devil's lettuce.
No, no, you dabble in the lettuce, and it somehow affects me. That's what happens.
I'm going to cherish this audio.
You dabble in somehow.
Wait, here we go. Here we go.
Big overhand looping right, that just barely missed.
This guy's coming out quick here. Ooh.
The head movement by Collin, I think, is going to be a big thing. I mean, I love Brandon Emmons, his style of fight. He comes straight forward.
Nice body
shot. Very aggressive. But
he's got to watch getting too aggressive, too, because Collin has some very good wrestling.
Yeah, but his movement. Just watch his fluid movement. Like, Emmons kind of keeps his head on a straight line right now, and he needs to not do that. He needs to move it a little more. I know he hits hard. I mean, we've seen in a lot of his previous fights, he's very well-rounded, but... By the way, I'm going to start bringing my own equipment to...
You don't have your own equipment.
You don't know that?
I'm here to back you guys up.
You don't know that.
Nice teep by Brandon. Both men exchange a jab right there.
Brandon needs to just move his head a little bit more. Just a little bit more. Nice short jab. Very solid, though, by Collin. Collin's jab is a nice, solid. It's as good as it's going to get. It's doing more damage than anything else this fight so far. Emmons' nose is busted open right now. His face reddening up, and it's mainly Collin just throwing out these jabs that are just sticking hard.
Slips that jab, slips another one. I think Brandon heard you.
Oh, there it is.
Gets a nice right two, right down the center.
Anglin has a different type of swag than I remember him having in the past.
He's looking like the All-American. He's looking like Guile over here.
Ooh, a little Street Fighter reference.
Yes. No, he's not backing Emmons up that much, though.
No, he's not. Emmons is still coming straight forward, but that doesn't mean Emmons isn't taking damage.
He's taking damage right to the chin. He ain't afraid of it.
No, he's not afraid of it, because I don't think it's hurting him a lot. I just think, like, dude.
Nice head kick. Clipped the shoulder. Yeah,
Shots build up, and they do damage over time. Nice right hand.
Yeah, Collin don't look like he's taking much yet. Emmons is definitely taking a few shots.
Ooh, another right to the chin.
That was explosive.
Brandon shook him off, but a lot of times that just means that
Emmons hurt. Collin's quick.
He's always been quick and a well-rounded fighter. But the demeanor and the
nice little shovel uppercut.
The demeanor and the swagger he brings into this fight right now is a different from what I'm used to seeing from Collin.
A little more confidence.
Yeah,
here.
I mean, after rattling off, I guess, two in a row now, he definitely starting to come into his own. But
wow, there's another. Oh, he's connected again. Emmons backs him up. A little more respect here.
Nice body kick. I think he got blocked though by an elbow.
Collin's eyeing him up. He's really.
Wants to go for that kick again. Miss.
Body shot.
Another over and right. Left, right.
It's Collin's weird movement that's given Brandon some problems and allowing Collin to.
Yeah, you can't. It's not predictable.
He's quick.
Wow.
Very quick.
He's able to get away with this weird movement with having his hands down.
It doesn't look like he's got a reach advantage on Emmons, but he's definitely moving around him enough to...
I actually think his reach advantage is slightly
less
yeah, but he's waiting.
So fast.
He's literally waiting for Collin, or for Brandon to come in, and every chance he does, that movement, a slight adjust off to the side, and he's throwing
counter.
Throwing straight. That's what's the big difference right now is how technical.
Oh,
he is really fighting. Ooh,
all right, he's got Emmons is bleeding here.
Everything is so quick and so straight. There's nothing sloppy. Collin did not throw
great
one
round.
Collin did not throw one sloppy punch
not,
that
yeah.
whole round.
Anglin's looking good.
The whole round, not one sloppy punch. That's the difference. I'm not saying Emmons has thrown sloppy punches, but his shots are very straight and, you know what I mean, a tad bit quicker. Emmons has either got to pick up the speed a little bit, or he's got to, you know, use that reach advantage, step back, and not allow Collin to counter him every opportunity. Because that's what he's doing. He's rushing in. He's keeping his head on a straight line. He's not moving his head. He's keeping his head on a straight line. He's an easy target.
It's not helping the way Collin moves. Collin
yeah,
moves.
Collin,
that's what I said.
He's moving one way, and then he'll fake that way, go a different way.
No,
it's almost like the Dominic Cruz type movement that Dominic does.
Dominic Cruz-esque movements.
And, you know, we were listening to the Joe Rogan podcast on the way out here, and Travis Barker had said that, you know, a lot of these fighters are adopting and making it their own. And Collin's doing that. And it's allowing him to keep his hands down a little
Collin's
more.
Ready to go already, guys.
That's one thing you can count on from the Scorpion Fighting Systems is their guys always come in shape.
Emmett's got a little bit of damage here.
Oh, he's bleeding.
Yeah.
That's normal for an Emmons fight. Nice chopping leg kick by Collin.
Okay.
I mean, scar tissue over time, no matter what.
Classic
being
Guida.
Being a fighter. You
a little bit of Guida going on here. Collin's just looking good.
No, real good. Emmons not really looking bad.
No, I know.
This round, he's starting off a lot fresher, though.
He's getting maybe, here we go. He's backing him up a little bit more.
Well, towards the end of that first round, he was starting to pick up his pace a little bit. You know, Emmons was.
I mean, the sting's wearing off just a little bit here. Not quite as
I mean, that's Emmons, though. Emmons is one of those guys that takes him.
Oh, headshot from Emmons.
But
he's
there.
Oh, yeah, he's
definitely
he's stepping up here.
Nice body shot.
He's using that reach I was saying just a minute ago. Like,
ooh.
If you're going to fight somebody that's, you know, going to be able to counter you because they're shorter and things like that, and they're waiting, stay at the end of your shots. Stick as far as you can, know your reach, and use it.
Collin's still looking very clear here. Emmons taking more shots to the face.
Nice chopping leg kick by Brandon. Side kick.
He's changing up his
Collin took a big deep breath just before he caught that jab on the chin.
Because he took a body shot just before that.
Another one. More
mouths wide open.
Yep, more red coming here from
nice elbow over the top.
Did it connect? Oh, that one connected.
Wow.
That connected.
Jesus,
that shot
Collin so fast. Here we go. Collin Anglin capitalizing here.
Nice flurry of shots from Collin.
Wow.
Somebody's mouthpiece.
Brandon Emmons.
Oh,
he's ready to go. I like
Brandon's
this.
Brandon's got the cooties now.
I like this. He's getting tagged, but he's not backing down.
Well, they didn't rinse that out, so Brandon now has athlete's foot of the mouth. Nice 1-2 by Brandon.
This is what this sport is made of right here. There have been some true...
Ooh, low leg kick by Collin.
There have been
right
some true,
the cat.
True, true warriors in this cage tonight.
Got a little jawing back and forth between Cody Brundage and Corey Wirtz.
We got Emmons still running Collin around the ring, but Collin he's quick,
he's
precise. He's landing his shots.
That movement that he started with in the first round, he's still using it now.
Yeah. And Emmons is still backing Collin around, but
hey, if Emmons was using the same movement that he's using now in the first round, his face would not be looking as bad as it is. I called it in the first round. He wasn't moving his head or doing anything that the right way. And now he's finally realizing he's having to move more and more. Had he caught on to that a little bit sooner, I don't think he'd be looking as bad as he is right now. But he's still in this fight.
Yeah, he is still in this fight. And the crazy thing is he's still running down Collin.
Yeah, he is. Oh,
nice left hook that puts Brandon down. looking for a front leg lock here. And he's looking to cinch up that guillotine choke. Brandon do a good job of hand fighting. Nice knee. And the ref saves Brandon. On between Collin Anglin and Corey Wirtz.
You know, I got to say, not knowing either of these fighters like you guys do for them from their background, I'm a Collin Anglin fan, man. His speed, his precision with his punches, he chose his swings. His movement was incredible, and not taking anything away from Emmons either.
No.
Emmons was a hell of a fighter through this whole thing.
I'm not saying, okay, so what I'm going to say right now is that was not an early stoppage, but even as they stopped the fight, Emmons is like, why? He was still in it.
No, I agree. I agree completely. Emmons has got a solid chin. He was ready to keep going, but just the precision and the choices in Collin Anglin's just incredible. He's a great fighter, and I think you're going to see a lot more from that guy.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah, he moves to 4-1 in his career.
And I think we might have a potential opponent for him in the next.
I think so. I mean, if Corey gets out of his next fight unscathed.
I don't think he'll be unscathed because he's fighting a tough guy.
He does have a tough guy.
Interesting. I could see that.
But No, I don't think you realized what just happened a second ago.
No, I have no idea. They were drawn back. No, I heard that part.
Okay, well, when Collin won the fight just now, he literally ran at the cage, flipped off Corey Wirtz, and then kicked the cage. Like,